Dear students, now we are into the 10th session of software engineering. After finishing two chapters, okay, the chapter 1 was a very short chapter, having just 3 topics. Chapter 2 is having 5 topics, and now we are into chapter 3, process models. Okay, so in this chapter, we will be studying various topics, that is waterfall model, okay, incremental process model, evolutionary process model, specialized process model, and finally the unified approach which will use all these models. So the topics covered here are the various models that we'll be considering for the process. Okay, as a software is developed, we have to adopt certain process models. Okay, various technologies, okay, software engineers have developed model, and we'll be studying them one after another. Okay, so in the unified process, we'll be using the best of all these models. So today we'll learn the very basic model, that is waterfall model. You very well know that waterfall model is applicable when the requirements of the task are fully known in advance. Okay, that is the problem is well understood. So problem must be very clear and the requirement should be understood. Okay, they should be known in advance and they should be stable, that is they should not change considerably. Okay, so here requirements must be known in advance and they should be stable. As well, the work flows from communication phase to deployment phase in reasonably linear manner. As you know, in a process model there are various stages. First is the communication stage. Okay, in the communication stage we gather lot of information or we do requirement gathering. Next phase is planning phase. Okay, in that case we plan for the project. Okay, and next case is modeling. You adopt certain model for the software that you are going to develop, the project that you have taken. Next we construct. In this case we write the code and test the programs. And finally the last case is deployment. So in the waterfall model, okay, the work from communication to deployment should move in a linear manner. That is, after the one stage is over, it should go to the next stage. Okay, waterfall model is sometimes called as classical life cycle. Okay, this waterfall model is the first model that was developed and is adopted. So it is called, and it has given birth to other models. Other models are based on principle of this with certain changes or certain modifications. That is why waterfall model is sometimes called as classical life cycle. And as I have told you, it is the oldest paradigm for software engineering. It is the first model it has developed. Okay? So it is the oldest model. Next, this is the diagram, okay, which depicts the process of waterfall model. What you find here in waterfall model is that first phase is communication. Okay, you are well aware the first phase in any process model is communication. Next is planning. Okay, planning, next stage, third stage is modeling, fourth stage is construction, and last stage is deployment. Okay, so the first stage is communication, second is planning, third is modeling, next is construction, and last is deployment. Okay, so the communication phase consists of two tasks, that is project initiation requirement gathering. That is, in this phase, we get lot of information from the customer, understand their requirement, and that will mark the initiation of the project. Once this communication phase is over, then we go to planning phase. That is, once a lot of analysis has been done, we have to plan for the software project, and it consists of various tasks such as estimating, scheduling, and tracking. Okay, that is, we should estimate total resources required, time required, manpower required. Okay, so this estimation should be done before so that project becomes successful. Scheduling of activities is also important. Okay, because they should be scheduled in linear manner, and you should track the activities whether they are going in the phased manner or no. All these are very challenging. Next is modeling. So, okay, for common understanding between the customer and the software team, there a model is developed. Okay, and next we carry out design. Okay, we carry out the design phase where we write the algorithm or whether we going for flowchart for the various programs that are required to be written. So, after the modeling phase, next phase is construction. So, this is the phase where we write the programs. Okay, that is the main task is done here, and then we test those programs for the required output. If there are any errors, okay, or any flaws, we remove them in this phase, construction phase. And last phase is deployment. Okay, in the deployment phase, we take this project on the on-site at the customer end and make it operational. So there, the tasks are delivery, support, and feedback. That is, in delivery phase task, we hand over the software to the customer and we give the necessary training, hands-on training to the customer, and as well as we take feedback from them. So feedback will help us to improve. Next, so what? First phase is communication, second is planning, third is modeling, next is construction, and next is deployment. In the waterfall model, the concept is that once the communication phase is over, then the planning phase begins. And once the planning phase is over, then the modeling phase begins. And the construction phase is next, and finally the deployment. There is improvement over this model where there is a feedback part. Okay? But mostly it is not widely adopted. So there are problems with this waterfall model. Okay? So what are the problems with waterfall model? The problem is that real projects rarely follow sequential flow that model proposes. So in the reality, we do not find that we complete one phase and then we go to the next phase. But in reality, okay, after going to the next phase, we may have to come back. Okay, or two phases might be going in parallel. Okay, so this model, as it proposes, that sequential flow is not very adopted. Next, it is difficult for customer to state all the requirement explicitly, as customer is also new. Okay, as he gets to know the requirements, he will pass on to the developing team. So initially, even the customer is not totally aware about the requirement. Next, it cannot accommodate uncertainties that every project has in the beginning. As in the waterfall model, we know that all the requirements must be known in advance and they should be stable. But in reality, the it is dynamic in nature. That is, requirements may slightly change, which this model doesn't accommodate. And finally, the customer must have patience. Okay, because in this model, the customer is given the project at last. Okay, so customer has to wait till the complete process is over. Okay, it is handed over to the customer at the deployment stage. So customer should wait for the delivery of the project. Okay, so it is a very first model or fundamental model. Okay, we'll be studying few more models. Okay, so this lays the foundation for all the models. Thank you.